Can English wine, yes, you heard right, English wine, compete on the world stage? Here to help us answer this vexing question is WSJ's wine columnist, William Lyons. Hello, William. Thanks so much for being with us.
Hi, Tanya. Great to be on the show and great to be talking about English wine from England.
Absolutely. Actually. And I have here a sparkling white from Ridgeview Estates, the Cavendish, and you, William, have the rosé. But before we get to the tasting, yes, I want to ask you, English wine, I mean, isn't England better known for its beer or gin?
Well, you're absolutely right. And I think if I pitched this story 25 years ago, I would have been laughed out of the newspaper. But funny enough, since the mid-1990s, England has had a burgeoning wine industry, and in the last 10 years it's really caught on. It's won a slew of international medals, and now we have more than 500 wineries here producing around 2 million bottles a year.
Fantastic. And what are the major styles, white or red?
Well, look, we are a northerly climate. We may be sort of warmed by the Gulf Stream, but it's mainly white wine. 80% is white wine. But the key to understanding English sparkling wine and its success is this: it's bubbles.
Mm.
This is the one product we do very well over here.
All right, so our image of England as a rainy little island, we need to rethink that.
In a way, we do. I mean, I don't know about the climate. Everyone talks about the climate change. But what I do is I've crunched the numbers. And actually, the soil isn't too different here in England than it is in Champagne. Also, during the growing season, we only have a sort of variant of temperature of about 1 degree, which is perfect for ripening grapes.
And you say in your piece that there have been comparisons with Champagne. Is it as good as Champagne, William?
Well, this is the big thing. This is what always gets the headlines, and over here we're obsessed with it. I think it's because the Brits drink more champagne than any other country in the world. But for me, English sparkling wine can now stand on its own 2 feet. It's a little bit different to champagne. If you come to London and you order a glass of English sparkling wine, it's a wonderful aperitif. It's a wonderful pick-me-up. It has searing acidity, quite sort of tart fruit, and also a flowery flavour, which I'm sure we can taste in a minute. But I think it's separate to champagne now, and I think it should have the confidence to go out and say exactly what it is.
All right, William, let's taste. Cheers.
Okay. Cheers. So, Tanya, is this your first time you ever tasted a sip of English sparkling wine?
It is, and I have to say I quite like it. It's refreshing and tart. A little delicate fruit, maybe.
Well, have a look at this. I mean, I've got the Fitzrovia 2011 from Ridgeview, and I chose Ridgeview because I thought they were the sort of closest style to champagne. And just look at this glorious sort of salmon pink colour and this white mousse.
Beautiful.
And the aromatics. I mean, I've got sort of flowery, but it's also
clean and crisp as well.
Clean and crisp, and we get a wonderful red currant tartness there. Lovely bright acidity.
I'm sold, but what say you, William, the expert? Has English wine arrived?
Well, I think there's two things that I would say as a caveat. Certainly in terms of quality, it's undoubtedly up there. It can stand shoulder to shoulder with all the best sparkling wines in the world there. Yeah, I really strongly agree with that.
All right.
But the caveat I would say, Tanya, just quickly, is there's a tiny production and the price is still quite high.
All right, so let's hope they speed that up and lower the price, because I'm on board. Thank you so much, William.
Pleasure. Thanks, Tanya.